the center of this zone is a sacred icon critical to the Great Journey. I must find it.
We shall cut into the heart of this infestation, retrieve the icon, and burn any flood that stands in our way. The parasite is not to be trifled with. I hope you know what you're doing.
Forward, warriors, and fear not pain or death. Go on. I'll follow when our reinforcements arrive.
Enforcers, to the vehicles. We need their heavy guns. Onward to the sacred icon.
Right out.
Nicely done. Hey!
Was working so well.
Keep moving. I'm on my way.
Goodbye.
Excruciating pain!
That was unfortunate. All the good vehicles got blown up. Yikes. Gotta pay closer attention.
Squander their talents.
Come on, man. Not off to a very good start. Anybody else? Oh, sweet mother Christmas. Oh. It just felt like it kind of came out of nowhere. That's all right, though. I took a little bit of a break, and now I'm back. Since I created all of these in advance, there won't be a break in videos. Thanks to YouTube's handy scheduling feature. Squish!
This is what we had back in the day. Instead of squishmallows, you see, we just squished the flood. Get it? Squishmallows. Knock, 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 knock.
You want a piece? I got something for you. Ain't nobody sneaking up anymore. Not today. Been watching other Halo content and just general gaming content. It seems like there's a lot of different groups of people, some who have been around for a while, and a lot who kind of seem like they still game, but they're not quite sure why. They're not really having fun, so they're not entirely sure why they're doing it. I think at its core, gaming has to be fun. You know, we can enjoy the art, the gameplay, the memories created with our friends, or even just the great single-player stories that you're playing by yourself. However, if you're not having fun, something is seriously wrong. I look at some games and I don't know what I'm looking at. I don't need 800 skins or, you know, digital goods out the wazoo to customize my character. I need a game to be fun. And older gamers especially, it seems like there's a decent amount of people out there who don't know why they game. And if this video serves any purpose, I would say, look at why you're doing it. I'm having fun. I know, thanks to the years that I had with MLG, I know I am nowhere near, even in my prime, nowhere near the level of a lot of these pro gamers. So competition, while I enjoy it, I know there's a certain level where I'm gonna get spanked, putting it mildly. So for me, fun has to be a key part of the equation. So if you're an older gamer, drop a comment. Maybe you're wondering, why am I doing this? And if you are, I would encourage you to take a break and really just play games that are fun, period, full stop. I see people having just as much fun with games like GoldenEye or games that are, you know, 10, 15, 20, 30 years old. If you're having fun, don't allow anyone to look down on you, especially some person on the internet. Negative comments are a dime a dozen. Gamers need to find a way to lift each other up. I remember the first 2 weeks of Xbox Live, everybody was just excited to talk to each other. And then people realized they could say things like bleep my bleep with no consequences, for the most part. So, just some things to think about. If the energy you're putting out into the world is horrible or inconsistent with who you are as a person, that's a you problem. And you shouldn't take to gaming to beat people down. If you do, you are sad and you are small. And I'm not talking about beating somebody in a competitive game. Competition is no fun with everybody's a winner. That's not what I'm talking about. And if I need to explain beyond that, watch that again. Something that everyone, everywhere, could do online is not take themselves too seriously.
I'm sending you a squad of my most experienced warriors, officer. Do not squander their talent.
I call that move going the wrong way. Don't suck, got it. Great advice. Real motivational. Was not expecting to find a shotgun out here, but against the flood? Okay then. Oh! That concludes the 2-for-1 Wraith special. Thanks for stopping by. I wonder. I shouldn't do it, but I'm going to. Oh! That worked out pretty good. Oh, good lord. I might as well just put myself right in the kill box. Okay. Alright, fella. I see you. Yeah, you ain't getting your greasy metal mitts on this fella. I swear those fruitcakes don't have any. Is very hard to hit them. Maybe I shouldn't have made that such a fair fight. I'll just peek out of my little hidey hole. Thank you. Oh. That was nice. I feel good about that. Now watch, somebody sneaks up on me and I get murked. Alright. Looks like I will be taking a stroll on foot. Tempting. Thank you. That's crap. I should just whip out my sword at that point. Stop doing that. Oh, that was horrendous. Yeah, let's just start that over. Come on, man. You gotta do better than that. Oh, I would've gotten rocketed. Oh. That would've been unfortunate.
Thank you.
Can't see nothing in the dark. I deserve that. That was pathetic. Oh, come on now. I did the same darn thing. I got caught on the same corner. Come here, fellas. Oh, sweet Christmas. If only I had some grenades. Timing. See, maybe I can lure them. Problem is, I don't have any good grenades. Come here, fella. Yeah, you just come on out. Nope, we don't need that. Can't win. I need some kind of explosive that I don't have. I can't lure them. So what? What is an owl to do? For one, I'm pretty sure, yep, that's the wrong way. Still found a grenade though, so worth it. Maybe I can use what's left of this to at least buy myself a little leeway. Just a little peekaboo around the corner. Go back, yep, get my sword. Take another crack at it. Alright. I'll just pick this up and we'll be on our way. Part of why I made special mention of gamers who may be struggling with why they're gaming. Maybe it's a habit, maybe it's just been something you've always done. I bought a house some time ago and I moved into a situation where I had the worst internet of all time. I'm talking about stepping back into like the early 2000s where DSL was considered high speed. So literally until President Biden made rural internet happen for a lot of us folks out here. And he did. I know that for a fact. I only had one choice, and that choice was terrible. So, I could still download games from Steam at a somewhat reasonable speed, but online play was out of it for years, basically until this year. So I never even thought of doing a YouTube channel or any sort of live anything until now, because it literally wasn't possible. So I played a lot of single player, and just wanted to say, for those of you older guys, or just whoever you might be, if you are wondering why you game, isolation is a good way to kind of figure that out. Especially when you're older, your challenges are balancing your time, making sure you're spending it the right way and not just gaming 24/7. I think balance is something that a lot of older gamers should at least think about. And I find I get more enjoyment playing less, which sounds weird, but those days of all-night Halo marathons or whatever your game of choice is, for someone in my situation, those days are very much over. They're gone. And to be honest, I don't have the stamina to do that anymore. So my point is, I don't know if I have a point. I'm just sharing my particular story. And playing a lot of those single-player games really helped me just to enjoy my own experience absent any sort of multiplayer interactions. And if you can do that, well, it certainly helps when you're trying to figure out how to balance your time. Like I said, these are unscripted, so these are pretty much just unfiltered thoughts. I think a lot about balancing my time. Not in a negative way, but just in a responsible way. I'll have to go get that rocket launcher a little more with a little more planning, now that I know that it's there. You gotta be kidding me. What was that, like two ghost shots? Alright. I took that personally. Oh! Okay. There we go. Okay. You have got to be kidding me. That was the most ridiculous shot I've ever seen. Ain't no way. Ain't no way, like, three little ghost shots killed me. Anyways, complaining is done. Thank you. Get out of my way. Yeah, no, don't. Yeah, go do literally anything other than stay next to me. And start firing at you. Yeah, get away from me. It's like, how can we be twice as explosive? Stand together. Like, we're not joined at the hips, guys. Come on, man. Alright, here we go. Nice little change of pace. I will say one thing I really enjoy about Halo 2 is they changed up the way the levels flow. And I think it kind of keeps, especially these final levels, it keeps them from getting stale, because you're not just confronted with open space after open space after open space. It's like, now you gotta ditch the scorpion, and I don't know, for me it just kind of keeps it fresh.
Icon.
On your way, Arbiter. I'll deal with these beasts.
Fence Tartarus, but I'm not gonna hold my breath. He doesn't care.
Look up ahead. The parasite gathers for an attack.
Kinda looking forward to killing him.
Thank you.
I just can't get over how beautiful the level design is. Just like even a moving platform is a work of art. Wow. I literally walked right into that one. Thank you. Oh crap, this looks familiar. Thankfully, the level designers didn't take us through another redux of the library. Here we go.
You know, your father never asked me for help either.
The index is secure.
Mackenzie, Perez, how's our exit? You hear me, Marines? We got trouble.
What's your responsibility? Now it is mine. A bloody fate awaits you and the rest of your incompetent race. And I, Tartarus, chieftain of the brutes, will send you to it.
And the prophets learn of this, that they will take your head
when they learn.